outside. Everybody rebound the ball. Nobody takes off till we get the rebound, and then you can have some fun and break. All right. Made or missed, good call, bad call, doesn't influence the way you play. It's a good call, goes in our favor, you're going to play the same emotion. It's a bad call, goes against us, you play with the same emotion. Doesn't matter. If we hit a bump in the road and there's some adversity, get yourselves together and play through it. Your shot's not falling, take the ball to the basket or make one more pass. Play hard, play with confidence. You'll have a good time and we'll come out all right. Anybody got any questions? Get to go 12 after free throws. Be aggressive with the ball. Be aggressive with the ball. Don't worry about making mistakes. You're going to. Don't worry about it. Just keep playing.
Let's see if they're a little good.
Westchester head coach Ed Azam addressing his players, and Tate George, obviously a lot of the focus on LeBron James, but who guards him tonight?
Well, Trevor Ariza, also, how about the message? The message from the coach, and here you see Trevor committed to UCLA. He's going to have that task to plan, but they seem ready. And see, what I liked about what the coach said, he's calm.
Yep.
You know, he's saying to him, listen, it's going to be a little different, but play with the same emotion. Bob, you know, that's important to kids to hear coming out in this type of a game.
Calm and confident and trying to instill that in his team as well.
Starting lineups and the opening tip-off just moments away. LeBron James is back on the floor. We're back in a moment.
Of evolution have created over 100
standing room only inside Sovereign Bank Arena here in Trenton, New Jersey for the 2003 primetime shootout, but more specifically for LeBron James and the St-Vincent St.Mary basketball team as they get set to take on Westchester High School out of Los Angeles. St-Vincent St.Mary, the top-ranked team in the country, gentlemen. But Westchester ranked at number 7, and we've talked about it over the last few days. This is a team not easily intimidated. They really think that they can win this game tonight.
Well, they knocked off the number 2-ranked team in the country in Fairfax 2 weeks ago, so trying to make it 2 weeks straight, knocking off a higher-ranked opponent.
I think it's going to take, I understand Westchester being a good team, but I don't think they've ever played in this type of atmosphere. See,
no.
The advantage goes to LeBron and his team. They are accustomed to this road trip and the touring and the entourage and the hotel security. It's a little different with this other club.
And the thing that's so amazing about LeBron, he thrives on this type of energy. Some guys all of a sudden go into a cocoon because of all the attention. Not so with him. He thrives on it and seems to elevate his game when all of a sudden everything else is surrounding him.
And you heard in the piece, they talked about, I'll show you when I feel like showing you. I can turn it on and off when I want, but, you know, he doesn't disappoint.
Guys, obviously LeBron, ultra-talented as a player, but one of the more impressive things, his teammates and his coaches love playing with LeBron James. Let's listen in.
The great thing about this group is that they've grown up together. They've been playing basketball together for a long time. LeBron has been the star of that group for a long time, but they recognize that he's just their friend, and that's how they approach it.
The great part about playing with him is it's just exciting. I mean, he's going to get everybody involved. I mean, he's not a selfish player, and he wants to win. And when a leader like that wants to win, it rubs off on everybody else.
As an adult, sometimes you think there's more important things going on in the world than a high school basketball player. And, you know, granted, he is one of the best high school basketball players I've ever seen. There's no question about it. And I've seen a lot, even just right here in Ohio. But it's still, it just seems like, wow, that many people want to talk to LeBron James, and he's just a high school basketball player.
It's crazy, because I was over his house last night. Before I went home, I see somebody sent him a little action figure of himself dunking the ball. It was like, you got action figures? This guy's still in high school. It's nuts. It's a whole nother level.
Take a look at the rankings of teams in the primetime shootout, according to USA Today. And talked about St. Vincent St. Mary at the top of the group. And that one loss, of course, coming in the game that LeBron James was suspended.
Actually, the game they had to forfeit against Buchtel from out in Akron, Ohio. They were able to win the game against McKinley out of Canton, Ohio, without LeBron James, a 63-62 win that kept them in that number one spot.
And guys, you listen to that last piece. Drew Joyce, the head coach of this Fighting Irish team, he's had a tough task trying to shield his young players from all the hype and all the attention. Joyce has closed his practices and he's banned his players from talking to the press and really trying to shield these young guys. Keep in mind, these guys are 17, 18 years old.
And on the other hand, you look at it too, I talked to him this morning at breakfast, and he said, hey, I didn't ask for this, but my advice to him was, hey, you have been put in this position because you can handle it. Make the best of it.
And certainly there's no textbook to how you're going to handle your team. You can't get a coaching. There he comes out. Listen to this roar.
Fans have made the 7-hour bus ride from Akron, Ohio.
They've even got
440-mile trek.
They've even got the handshake down.
Oh, yeah.
We got to work on that at halftime.
The thing that's amazing, going through warm-ups, everybody's standing up. You've never seen anything like it. But that's not just here. The same thing happened in their game in Greensboro a couple weeks ago. Talking to Bob Gibbons, the recruiting guru who sees as much high school basketball as anybody, said, I've never seen anything like it. The crowd is going crazy during warm-ups watching this guy.
Take a look at these starters first for the Fighting Irish. The backcourt, Corey Jones, Drew Joyce. The front line featuring three forwards with Cotton, LeBron James, and very talented Romeo Travis. And we'll be talking about Travis all throughout this game, a 6'6 senior.
Going to Akron, two other Division I players on this team. Also a very experienced team with the four senior starters.
LeBron James scanning his eligibility just about a week or so ago, and a lot of people, was the argument, they felt that James should just shut it down. Millions of dollars to be made in the NBA, but what people don't realize is this guy's 18 years old. He's not going to have the college experience. He wants to enjoy his final few days as an amateur athlete.
And he wants to win another Ohio State championship, something he did as a freshman and sophomore. They lost last year in the championship game against Roger Bacon, so he's got unfinished business.
Take a look at the starting lineup for Westchester. Backcourt, Jonathan Tolliver and Bobby Brown up front. Scott Cutley, Trevor Ariza, UCLA bound, a 6'9 senior forward. And Marcus Johnson, a sophomore, listed at 6'6.
I ran into Marcus Johnson in the lobby, and I said, what did you feel when they said you're going to play the number one team? He said, we look forward to it.
Oh, yeah. I mean, that's a challenge, and everybody wants an opportunity to get a chance to play against LeBron James. Why not?
And you notice that the tattoos being covered on, I guess, Ohio rules. The administration or the committee tells you that you can't show tattoos, so they have the patches on. And wow.
Well, we're set to jump it up. It is Romeo Travis, a 6'6 forward, against Marcus Johnson, also at 6'6. The number one ranked high school team of the country against number 7 in Westchester. And the tap is controlled by the Comets. Marcus Johnson trying to find a teammate, Ariza, but his pass knocked out of bounds. Last touched by the Fighting Irish. And LeBron James trying to make his presence felt on the defensive end right off the bat.
That's the thing. Sometimes people question how good of a defender is he. Well, one thing's for sure, he's such a good athlete that when he concentrates at that end of the floor, he can be just as dominant defensively as offensively.
Scott Cutley trying to go backdoor to Ariza. Miscommunication there as Westchester turns it over.
One thing about Westchester, they like to get up and put pressure on you for the entire game. They're a very deep team, run a lot of guys in and out. They want to force the pace.
Romeo Travis, now LeBron James with his first touch. Cross court, there's an open three-pointer off the mark by Corey Jones. And back come the Comets quickly.
Jones is a dead-eye three-point shooter. You got to get out and find him.
And there is Trevor Ariza. A little bit off his rhythm in the first few seconds of the game. Another turnover by Westchester.
Well, this press, if they can break it, they've got the advantage right here.
Yeah, when he's at the back end, that's it. That's a nice safety valve.
Jones looks for a teammate. Cotton, top of the arc to Drew Joyce. Now LeBron James. Ill-advised pass by James. The steal by Johnson. Oh, yeah. And he flushes it home. Marcus Johnson with the steal and finish on the other end.
And he's the star of the future for this Westchester team. You see his leaping ability out in transition. The quickness, though, defensively. Getting in the hand in the passing lane. Textbook denial defense right there. And then finishing with the dunk.
There's a lot of things LeBron's going to have to work on. I mean, as much as you have hype around him, he's still, once he goes to the next level, these guys are waiting on him. You know, I talked to a couple of guys down at the All-Star game. They said, we can't wait for him to get here to teach him how the game is supposed to be played at this level. Again, another turnover.
And here is Ariza in the open floor. And the emphatic two-handed stuff by Trevor Ariza. And a quick 4-0 lead for Westchester. And another ill-advised pass. The steal.
Look at the defense.
As Bobby Brown steps into the passing lane. And it will be Westchester basketball. And the Fighting Irish guys seem a bit rattled by all the noise and attention in this building. Timeout on the floor, 6:28 left to play in the early going.
Tier male rhinos are highly aggressive.
On Sunshine Network.
Spiro Dinas, Tate George, and Rob Kennedy back live from Sovereign Bank Arena, the 2003 primetime shootout. A quick 4-0 lead. Taken by Westchester High School. Here's Ariza down the lane, and he banks it home. Good-looking dribble drive by Trevor Ariza. He's headed to UCLA.
And they've done it with their defense. Two turnovers led to the first 4 points. They finally get one in the half court.
And finally, the first bucket as Romeo Travis is able to convert, and it's a 4-point game. Here's Brown, puts it on the floor. Good crisp ball movement by this Comets team in the early going. Brown fires a three-pointer way off the mark. But the offensive rebound is tracked down by Marcus Johnson.
And Westchester's got great team speed. You saw it right there, able to track down the offensive rebound.
Bad pass there by Brown as the Comets turn it over. And here is Drew Joyce, a playmaker for the Fighting Irish. Ball worked into the corner. James.
See, James is going to have to play hard. James has got to play harder. Trevor Ariza is guarding him very hard. And this is what James is going to have to work on, the defensive side. And if he can't guard at this level on a consistent basis, there's going to be a huge change in growth when he goes to the next level.
And a lazy pass there by James nearly turned it over.
Too many lazy passes because of the denial defense of Westchester.
Here's Travis back to the basket, back out for Joyce, around the horn. Now they give it to LeBron James. Turns and faces just inside the arc. And the first bucket on the night for LeBron James.
And as he now starts to consistently hit outside shots like that, watch out.
Here's Cutley into the corner. That's a three-point attempt off the mark by Jonathan Tolliver. And we get a whistle. It will be St. Vincent basketball.
Sizing up. Knocks down the 18-footer. See, he wants the ball, and they're conceding to him right now because he wants to put on a show.
You see Reese playing off of him. You got to get out and challenge James. He knocks down back-to-back deep shots on the left wing.
And that's a three-point field goal for LeBron James. A quick 5 points for him.
It's competitive.
It's a 7-0 run for the Fighting Irish.
And Spiro, his competitive nature. He's talking to the guy who's guarding him.
Foul a minute ago called on Trevor Ariza. His first personal. Brown, lazy pass, trying to find Cutley. It's taken by James. Attacks.
Wow.
And a gorgeous dribble drive and finish with the right-handed finger roll. And a lot of flash bulbs in this arena. And there is Cutley attacking. And a charging foul called against Westchester.
See, where he electrifies you, it's the extension to the basket. I mean, look at his head once he gets the ball. I mean, he is going up.
And good patience out on the break, too. He didn't rush it. He allows the defender to run by, and then no one's going to challenge him up at the rim.
Substitution for the Comets, Cameron Granville, a freshman guard, very talented, at 5'9", checks into the game. And he replaces Bobby Brown. Here's James back to the basket about 20 feet out. Dribbles through the legs, pulls up on a three-pointer. Ariza may have got a piece on it, but James steps into the passing lane, comes up with a steal.
His James second steal already.
Now to Joyce, trying to find Cyan Cotton. Here's Jones on the wing. Sloppy play now for both teams as the Fighting Irish turn it over.
And you're going to get some of that sloppy play. Obviously, with all the attention, sitting around all day knowing this game's coming, it's hard to all of a sudden get yourself in a nice rhythm.
Yeah.
Thomas trying to work on some spacing, bunched up in the corner. Here's Ariza, works baseline, goes around his man Cotton on the play, and ball knocked out of bounds, last touch by the Fighting Irish.
Well, when you watch James defensively, he takes a lot of gambles. He's taking chances because he's trying to make the highlight reel for the fans that pay the money.
Drew Joyce is now covering Trevor Ariza, gives up a lot of height to him. Here's a pull-up elbow jumper by Johnson off the mark. And LeBron James averages better than 10 rebounds per night as his first carom. Here's Travis. Tough spinning baseline jumper is off the mark. Westchester with the basketball down 3 points. There's a three-point attempt by Cutley, an air ball.
Both teams look a little winded right now.
Yeah, the excitement, they kind of got themselves caught up in it.
You got the adrenaline going, and all of a sudden now you start settling in, having to play basketball.
And LeBron James left open.
He's looking for a challenge.
Did you see him go right at Ariza?
Well, he's looking for the challenge.
Said, on you.
Great players, like much like Michael Jordan, they look for the challenge when they're out there on the floor.
Pass there by Johnson. Time for some razzle-dazzle. LeBron James with 10 very quick points.
And he gets his feet underneath him. Nice looking stroke right there. You see him come right at Ariza saying, you're going to have to come out and guard me. I don't care what people say about my inconsistent outside shot. How's that? Tagging three from just about the exact same spot.
Well, he'll get more excited and into the ball game as he poses a challenge. He's got to find someone on the floor who wants to step up and face him on that level. And right now, he's searching, and anyone who guards him, they're going to have to understand that he's going to come right at him.
A 12-0 run for St. Vincent St. Mary. They lead by 6 points. And trying to build on that lead.
And it's been a one-man run.
There's an outside offering by Drew Joyce off the mark. LeBron James working on the offensive glass. And a foul called underneath against Westchester.
And he came out tentative the first couple minutes. You talked about it needing to play harder. Well, now all of a sudden, a lot more energy. Moving without the basketball. You see right here, fighting for the offensive rebound, establishing that position inside. That's good effort on the offensive board.
A non-shooting foul. And so the Irish will inbound. Couple of substitutions. William McGee and Brandon Weems checking in for the Irish. James, pull-up elbow jumper. Rolls off the front of the rim. The rebound taken by Cutley and Westchester. We approach 2 minutes left to play. We're in the opening quarter here at the 2003 primetime shootout in Trenton, New Jersey. Cutley back to the basket, double teamed inside, had his shot partially blocked by Romeo Travis. But Cutley also hit on the arm, and so he'll step to the free throw line for two shots.
Cutley, the wide body warrior, be playing next year at the college level for Kent State, one of the top mid-major programs in the country. Jim Christensen has his team out to another terrific start this year. 20 wins already. You're this early into February and you've got 20 wins. It's saying a whole lot.
No, you're getting it done.
Scott Cutley in his senior season has already signed with Kent State. A much improved player. And he hits on the second free throw. Timeout on the floor. 1:57 left to play. First quarter in Trenton.
South Florida Lexus dealer.
The Isles primetime shootout is being brought to you in part by Keyspan Energy Delivery. The energy to think ahead. 1:57 left to play. Opening quarter. Between St. Vincent St. Mary and Westchester High School out of Los Angeles. LeBron James, quick start. 4 of 6 shooting, 10 points for LeBron, but the rest of his team guys just 1 of 4, 2 points. Here's Weems finding his man Joyce, working around the horn to Romeo Travis. Fighting Irish very patiently Cutler looking for an opening. McGee feeds James in the corner, turns and faces on Cutley, wants to take it. A little shake and bake, back to the basket. James tied up, falling away. And a reaching foul called against Scott Cutley. LeBron, very ambidextrous, uses both hands. He's a guy, of course, shoots right-handed, but he eats and writes with his left hand.
How about this right here? Gets him on a hand, able to gather himself back up. One of the things you talk about LeBron, I think what mesmerized everyone now is the Kobe Bryants who came before him kind of went under the radar. It wasn't as much of a big deal. But what amazes me is people treat him as if he is the first and the last to ever do this. You know, you had Dr. J and Lou Alcindor, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, Kobe Bryant, a lot of the guys, the Amani Stoudemire that are in the league now. I think everyone, the media, along with his play, has capitalized everything that he does.
And that's a great point. He's the next great player. Wasn't the first great player in high school, and he's not going to be the last. He's just the guy right now. Right.
Gorgeous move to the basket. Another great player on the floor tonight, Trevor Ariza, showing his talents as he works baseline. And Ariza now with 6 points, drawing some oohs and ahs from the crowd here.
Well, he's got some similar skills to LeBron James. He's got the ability to put the ball on the floor. He's long enough to finish up at the rim. Another guy, these wing, 6'9 wing guys that can play inside and out.
They're carbon copy. I mean, he may not have as many skills, but the same type body.
Yep.
They look just alike.
Just not as thick and strong is James.
And speaking of being strong, James just fights through his defender and knocks down the turnaround jumper. He now has 12 points.
The little lean just knocked Ariza right off him. There's that strength. That's the difference right now.
Dangerous pass. Ariza trying to save it. Fight for it, and it's taken by Travis James, one-on-one, into the lane, and a right-handed finger roll finish.
Wow. And he finishes like that, and it's a disappointment from everybody in the crowd. Did you see how many flash bulbs went off?
There's a three-pointer, and the answer by Westchester, as Jonathan Tolliver, the junior guard, knocks it down.
Westchester's stepping up to the challenge, and that's what you want to see at this level. Kids are going to step up to the challenge and not get caught up in the hype.
Hey, they're one of the best programs in the country. Year in, year out, won a state championship last year. Nothing new for them.
James over two defenders falling away. Ill-advised shot by LeBron. Back come the Comets, three on one.
Nice.
Right
pass.
Back to Johnson. Misfires on the jam attempt, but he was fouled from behind. And Marcus Johnson to the free throw line with 8.8 seconds left. And this is a four-point basketball game.
And Ariza making the simple play. You know, in all this excitement, it would have been easy for him to try and go challenge with the dunk. Instead, the nice touch pass ahead, making the simple play.
The level of talent across the board that we've been covering the last couple days has been really remarkable.
And how about on that play? I saw you giving a little hand, huh? You like this one, huh?
Here you see it. You want to give it back. And again, the simple pass, as you mentioned, about, and going up to try to finish. And again, everyone's here to see LeBron. There's no question. But how about the other guys on both sides stepping up, you know, and wanting to play and challenge? Marcus Johnson, I told you, running to him into the lobby, you can see the gleam in his eye that, hey, I am here to play.
It might be his stage, but these guys are on the same stage with him.
Exactly.
The officials say it will be Fighting Irish basketball. Corey Jones has been reinserted into the game. 6.2 seconds left in this first quarter. Westchester now applying some light full court pressure defense. James in the backcourt. Down to 2 seconds. James has to fire it up. And he banks it home.
How do you allow him to get the ball?
Well, as soon as he caught it, though, did you see him look up, find the clock? He knew exactly how much time was left. And when that ball left his hands, it's right on our angle. It was going the whole way.
They came to watch LeBron James, and 8 minutes complete. The super senior has not disappointed. He caps off the first quarter with a buzzer-beating three-pointer. He has 18 points.
Some of the rarest, most beautiful, and most sought after.
Use your legs. You guys travel because you're not balanced. You're not ready to play. You can't guard a guy because you're off balance. You're leaning forward. You're leaning sideways. Get on balance. You can guard a guy. I don't care if he hits a shot. I want him to hit a couple of those shots. Because later in the game, he's not going to. So we want him to do that. That's fine. Just get the damn ball out of the net and go. You go to two spot. Who's the three?
Westchester head coach Ed Azam. I want to thank all the head coaches here at the Primetime Shootout, agreeing to be mic'd for sound during this tournament. Start of the second quarter, James absorbs the contact, no call. Travis stays with it, and he cleans it up on the offensive glass.
Well, he's their second best player throughout the season, showing you why.
And there is Trevor Ariza on the other end, the bucket and the foul, a chance at the conventional three-point play.
Well, the coach was saying that during the timeout, get the ball, I won't use the words he used, but get the ball out and go. And here's James fouling Trevor, going to the basket.
Well, one thing, this team wants to get out and run every possession. And you're right, Coach, saying, push it. Just get the ball out of the net and let's run it up. Make sure the press isn't a factor.
So 9 points now for Trevor Ariza. LeBron James on the other end, 18 points. He's 3 of 4 from three-point distance. And we get another timeout. 7:34 left before halftime. It's a five-point game.
Good morning.
We welcome you back to Sovereign Bank Arena. Live coverage of the 2003 Primetime Shootout. St. Vincent St. Mary's with a 22-17 lead over Westchester High School out of Los Angeles, California. LeBron James, 18 points. He's 7 of 10 shooting the basketball. And James trying to break down the full court pressure defense. Hands to his teammate, Cyan Cotton. Over the timeline, trying to find a teammate. Finds Corey Jones. Now to the point guard, Drew Joyce. Guarded very tightly by Tolliver. Joyce gets a Travis screen. Fighting Irish very patiently in their half court set. Now James back to the basket. Into the lane. Right handed finish. LeBron James on the season averaging a shade under 30 per night. Already he has 20 points in this game. Here's Ariza into the corner. High arcing jumper from Tolliver, a three-point attempt. It's off the mark. And a foul called here against the Comets.
The thing that amazes you, he never disappoints, huh? All this stuff going on, stepping up 20 points already, doing it outside and also showing you he can go get it done inside as well.
In the playgrounds, you know what they describe him? He's for real.
Oh, yeah. He is the truth, right?
You run out of adjectives, you just say, oh, yeah, he's for real.
If you could live up to this kind of hype.
And that's the most amazing thing about him. He lives up to it.
Cotton over the midcourt line. Jones into the corner. Joyce thought about it. Now LeBron James. He's guarded by Jonathan Tolliver. James thought about it. Pulls up. He's off the mark, but he was hacked in the act. And so LeBron James to the free throw line with 6:24 left to play in this opening half.
And there's no question he's coming out and trying to make a statement, huh? With everything that's gone on, not being able to play their last game, he is stepping out. Every time he's got the ball, he's thinking about making big-time plays.
LeBron James, a guy who also performs in the classroom, has a grade point average of 3.5. He's gotten a bad rap with everything that's happened off the court, but very down to earth. His teammates love him. His classmates adore him. He's the class clown at St. Vincent St. Mary High School. And an all-around great young kid. There's an outside jumper by Bobby Brown. Short. Rebound taken by Cutley. Spins inside. Has it knocked away. Cutley stays with it, but it's out of bounds. Last touch by Westchester.
Cutley's trying. I mean, he's a little out of control. Coach talked about it. But gather yourself on the spin. I think he's rushing it because he feels that the guy's going to come down and block the shot.
You heard him talking about balance, you know, make sure that you got your feet under him. He didn't that time.
Romeo Travis has been yet to find a groove on the offensive end. Here's Ariza spinning baseline after a pump fake, a traveling violation. Tough call.
Nope, I agree. He had his pivot foot down. So many times you see officials make that call because they're watching the upper body and not their feet.
I tell you, the kids are very advanced. You see them moving the ball around. See the turnover. Westchester, if they can slow this down a little bit, they can get back in the game.
Travis And his shot partially blocked. Travis stays with it. Misses a third attempt. Still no good. James is there. He can't finish. And the rebound taken by Cutley. Four chances at it. Here's an alley-oop attempt. It's off the mark. Trying to go up top to Marcus Johnson.
Again, play within yourself. This play is not even here. Trying to make the play to excite the crowd. I don't know, unless you jump like Sparrow. I don't know anybody else that can go get that one.
They have the worst vertical leap in the country. Romeo Travis handing to Drew Joyce. Works along the wing. Nice stutter step. Goes baseline. Tries to float it in. Way short. Now a fight for it along the baseline. It's finally taken by Cutley in the Comets. Cutley dishes. A wing three-pointer is good by Bobby Brown.
That's the pace they want to play on.
So a five-point St. Vincent St. Mary lead. They have it. 25-20 with under 5 to play. James off a pump fake. Pull up baseline jumper short. And the rebound taken by the Comets. Brown, touch pass underneath. Ariza attacking the rim. And a blocking foul called underneath.
Sliding by the defender to make sure that he didn't pick up the charge. And instead, he's at the line.
Well, here's the play here. The leak out. The leak out and then goes right by him. You know, you want to see him jump around. That's excellent play.
So Trevor Ariza, the free throw line, a senior forward, 6'9". We mentioned he's already committed to UCLA.
McDonald's All-American game candidate.
Averaging close to 20 points per game for this Westchester team on the season. Ariza sets himself. And he rattles home the second free throw. Very loose rims in this building.
Well, everybody's been hanging on the rim since we got here.
Drew Joyce slowly dribbles his way over the midcourt stripe. Now finds Corey Jones. Here's Cyan Cotton. Travis. Hands to LeBron James. Gets a Cotton screen. Dribbles top of the arc. Jones left open. A three-pointer.
We said earlier he's a deadly three-point shooter. You got to get out and find him.
Here's Ariza facing up on James. One-on-one. Goes cross-court. Pull-up three-pointer. That's short as Tolliver misfires. Another chance after the offensive rebound for Westchester. And now Bobby Brown wants to reset. A nice decision. Tolliver, high arcing three-pointer, and he buries it.
He's not bashful.
6 points for Jonathan Tolliver, and he brings Westchester now to within 4 points. It's 28-24. Here's Joyce, wide open, a three-pointer, and he knocks it down.
Well, Joyce is their point guard. He runs this team, but he can also step out and knock down the threes. One of the reasons why he's a Division I recruit playing at Akron next year, along with Travis.
Drew Joyce, of course, the son of his head coach, Drew Joyce II.
And he plays like a coach's son.
I was about to say, how many coaches' sons cannot play the game of basketball?
James, nifty ball handling behind the back. Picks up his dribble. Cross court, Jones left open. And a shot partially blocked by Tolliver. Here's Ariza. Tempo starts to quicken. Three-pointer is off the mark by Brown. The tip-in attempt no good. As Robert McClinton, who's checked into the game, gets a hand on it.
Smart play here to just settle it down.
That's Romeo Travis losing the handle out of bounds. Fighting Irish turn it over.
St. Vincent St. Mary's continues to shoot the ball from the outside. LeBron James, one of the big reasons why they're 5 of 9 from beyond the three-point line.
Watch LeBron here. Not getting the ball and show a little bit of frustration.
Number one, Brandon Lee has arrived.
It is tough when you're the show. It took a while for Michael to get it. And I came into the league on his when he started winning championships, and you saw his growth. But when you watched him, and he got frustrated with guys not getting him the ball. But after a while, they ran that triple offense, and then he just started to get into a flow, and they won championships. If he ends up on the Cleveland Cavaliers, there's going to be a lot of frustration for some years. Because they're rebuilding, and they've got Wagner and a couple other guys. But
I wouldn't wish that on him right away. I'd hope he goes somewhere else.
It's one of the tough things when you're the number one pick. Most of the times you're going to be with a team that's going to struggle for a while.
Well, the people in Ohio want him home. Yep. Nothing wrong with Cleveland. They want him home, and I hope he gets there for their sake. But he's going to have some until he grows into it.
There's William McGee off the bench coming up with the steal. Now LeBron James works one-on-one against Ariza. The pull-up jumper outside. It's a two-point field goal.
Boy, he's been impressive from the perimeter.
23 for LeBron James. Here's a Westchester turnover. Chance for the Fighting Irish to build on a nine-point cushion. Johnson down low.
Oh! Well, that's what they all came to see, the athleticism of LeBron James on the put-back dunk.
They're up on their feet here at Sovereign Bank Arena. Comets trying to answer, and a charging foul called against Westchester. Ariza trying to answer, but he gets a little bit overly aggressive, and it will be Fighting Irish basketball. Timeout on the floor. 25 points for LeBron James. His last bucket on that putback attempt.
Uncommon things.
A very proud Gloria James, among the 10,000 or so spectators in attendance, making the long trek down from Akron, Ohio.
In the white shirt.
And her son, LeBron James, not your average 18-year-old, showing his talents on the national stage here tonight.
And then you see him here, jump shot after jump shot. What I like, when he takes the jump shot, he stays in the flow with the shot. And then here, at the extension.
He glides by people out in the open floor. Hey, if you need a three-pointer at the buzzer from 40 feet, I can do that too.
Underneath. He has it all. I mean, he really has it all.
Not much that he can't do on the basketball court.
And this Westchester team trying to hang around. This is a very critical final minute 38 before the halftime, trying to keep this game close. They trail right now by 11 points. They've hit a little bit of a lull here with their offense over the last few minutes.
Oh, LeBron having 25 to 35 points. Obviously, his mom's very proud. A lot made of that whole situation. And when we're in the lobby this morning, you know, the LeBron James or King James's entourage walked in. I really don't see a problem with having that because the kid is very young. He needs to have people that he's familiar with around him so that he doesn't get in those type of troubles. When he went off on his own, he got himself in trouble.
Here's James attacking at a shot partially blocked by Ariza.
Especially with all the attention that's coming from the outside, you need to surround yourself with some people to keep people away. We talked about his teammates sometimes creating a cocoon and keeping him inside.
LeBron James left open. The high arcing rainbow offering swishes through the nets.
He's going to get 50.
Oh, yeah. Dave Telp, one of the finest guys that does all the recruiting analysis on guys. He put the under over yesterday on 38. He was right on. I mean, you knew that he was going to come out and do something special, but 30 points with still a minute left to play in the first half? I mean, come on.
Well, the sad part for Westchester is that he sat out, so he's now angry. He's coming back with a vengeance, and he's trying to prove something to everybody, including everyone in the building.
Here's James, a couple three-pointer. It's good.
That's not fair. He's a little riled up and taking it out on Westchester right now.
And LeBron starting to bark to the crowd here at Sovereign Bank Arena. He has 31 points. He's 5 of 6 from three-point distance.
You figure there's no way he can live up to the hype, right?
No, wrong. I didn't think so. I mean, he's just a dunk away.
Final 20 seconds as Cutley drives to the basket and a charging foul called against the Comets, and this Westchester team may be in over its head right now.
Watch this. Left hand, step back, fall away. So he finishes. And what I like is the emotion. You know, he doesn't allow the crowd to stop him from being who he is. He claps on turnovers. He's up high-fiving the guys that are taking charges. He's not just making the basket. He's also creating the enthusiasm and electricity in the building.
Just seems to thrive off it.
Down to 12 seconds for the halftime intermission. They go right back to LeBron James. Why not? James pulls up. Flat-footed three-pointer short. Down to 3 seconds. Here is Tolliver trying to find his teammate. Brown comes up with it, but that would not have counted. An electrifying first-half performance.
I'll stand up and give him an applause for that.
By 18-year-old LeBron James, 31 points in 16 minutes of action. And the young fella has not disappointed. Halftime here in Trenton, New Jersey. St. Vincent St. Mary with a 17-point lead over Westchester. Here at Sovereign Bank Arena in Trenton, New Jersey, the 2003 primetime shootout. And what a show over the first 16 minutes of action. Right now we check into both locker rooms. First, Westchester and head coach Ed Azam.
Balance, trying to make moves and create things. We don't create. Right, maybe he can create shots. I mean, all he's doing is shooting fadeaways. Give them credit. Fine, they've gone in. That doesn't mean you stop playing. You go out there and do what he did and get tougher on defense instead of backing away. He gets the ball now. You guys are running for the other end. You guys don't want any part of it. You know why? Because your fucking egos are in it. Your individual egos are in this right now, and you don't want to be embarrassed. Well, then don't get on the goddamn court. Let somebody else play. He does something, so you got to go down there and try to do something on your own. Instead of setting the screen, making one more pass. We don't even need a 15-second shot clock. Yes, we want to run the ball down the floor. That doesn't mean we have to shoot it with one pass, two passes. If we don't have the advantage, you run an offense. You get proper spacing, you set screens for each other, you work for good shots. Whoever gets the good shot. But you're not trying to create stuff on your own offensively. And when the shot goes up, why aren't we rebounding the ball? Guy blocks you off, guy blocks you off, guy blocks you off. And all you do is just stand there and try and reach over. I'm asking myself, why are you still in the game? When they shoot the ball, what are you supposed to do? Box out. Right, that's what you're supposed to do. And then when you block out, then you go get the ball. You don't stand there and watch somebody else rebound the ball, which is what we're doing. They're blocking out. And you're upset because they block you out. They don't block out in volleyball. They block you out. Step around them. Get sideways or get inside. Don't stand there and watch the guy block you out. Let's get a few offensive boards. I'm going to get on the officials. Fine. You guys want to help me officiate? You better start worrying about playing because we're not doing a very good job of that. Maybe I can use some help coaching. But don't help me officiate.
The Westchester Comets shell-shocked in the halftime locker room. A 17-point lead for the Fighting Irish. Halftime continues in a moment.
Versatile, most exhilarating.
Ten on Sunshine.
Our halftime coverage continues here at Sovereign Bank Arena in Trenton, New Jersey for the 25th annual primetime shootout. And what a display over the first 16 minutes as we see LeBron James take over this game. Spiro Dinas, Tate George, and Rob Kennedy. And guys, we talked about James. He has lived up to the height in that first half of play. 31 points, 5 of 6 from three-point distance. We talked about being one of his weaknesses, that outside shot. Well, he's proving us wrong, isn't it?
It's almost as if he wanted to come out and prove that. He defended very well to start the game and then knocked down three-point shots. When he's hitting shots from the outside like that, you can't handle him. Not at this level.
Well, he's looking for the challenge, too. Yep. As he ran by us a couple
couple times, he's yelling, "You can't guard me." You know, we all kind of gave him a stand ovation going off the floor because he's playing so well. And he's living up to the hype like you talked about, Bob. You see the steal, though. Westchester gets out early. Was unfazed. The LeBron James factor had not set in yet.
Until he started hitting threes, and then all of a sudden, boy, did it settle in transition, sliding by guys, the ability to skate out in transition.
Clock running down. Who else gets it? I mean, you deny him the ball here. You don't allow him to come up. This is a momentum swing right here.
It's like I could do whatever I want to out here on the basketball court. Take you outside, take you inside, spin you back down, and after every basket, just turn it around saying, "Hey, you know what? You can't guard me." With that kind of athletic ability, you're right. Stepping over guys, dunking on them, and doing everything off the dribble. He came out to make a statement, and boy, did he do it here in the first half.
Look at the reaction.
They've come out in droves to watch LeBron James. He's already eclipsed his season average. Second half is next.
Not the excitement in your life? Then get to your South Florida Pfluger.
Halftime winds down here at Sovereign Bank Arena. St. Vincent St. Mary with a 17-point advantage. As we get set for the third quarter, Spiro Dinas, Tate George, and Rob Kennedy. And guys, you try to figure out a way for this Westchester team to get back into the game. First, they have to take care of the basketball, and they have to find a way to get Trevor Ariza some more shot attempts. He had just four shots in that first half.
Yeah, 10 points, but only four field goal attempts. He's their go-to guy. Well, you got to go to him and get him some shots.
Well, also, you look at the other side of it. Westchester turns the ball over way too much. I believe 15 turnovers. You can't beat anybody if you turn it over 15 times, 16 times. To five, that you're not going to be able to win.
And look at those field goal attempts. 34 attempts for St. Vincent St. Mary's to just 19 of Westchester, kicking the basketball all over the place.
And just four foul shots at the half for St. Vincent St. Mary, but despite that, they put up 41 points in 16 minutes.
And look at LeBron. He's up seven. He had 31 in the first half. Westchester's got 24. He single-handedly just took this game over.
LeBron James back from a one-game suspension. Of course, he'll have to serve out one more game, and he will serve that during their February 23rd. During a February 23rd game against Toledo. Start of the third quarter, the Fighting Irish with a 17-point lead. It's worked around the perimeter. Brown feeds inside. Here's Ariza into the corner. Now to Tolliver. High arcing three-pointer. Barely nicks the front portion of the rim. And the officials say it will be Fighting Irish basketball. This is the 2003 primetime shootout. A tournament that began back in 1977 with a four-team gathering. Here in 2003, it's become a national event as a pretty little baseline jumper falls through by Bobby Brown.
And Westchester needs the same start to the second half as they had to start the game.
Oh! More showtime. LeBron James soaring through the air as he jams it home.
What'd you say? He needed one more dunk to solidify it for you? Does that do it?
Give me the complete package.
You got it now.
Here's James into the corner. Turns and faces on Cutley. The crowd wants more. James back to the basket, spinning, double team, cross court. Jones thought about it, put it on the floor. And finally a whistle. And it will be Westchester basketball after the turnover.
Better find that guy because you can throw it as high as you want. Talk about alley-oops. He'll go wherever you're going to put it.
See, Jones is coming up, but normally, you see, when you're used to coming and stopping the ball. But you got to realize he's behind
you. Yeah.
And I think, if anything, you do exactly what that defender did. Go out to the ball. You don't want to be on the highlight reel.
Ball worked around the horn. Cutley trying to find a teammate, guarded tightly by Jones. Into the corner to Ariza. Attempted just four shots in the first half. Works baseline, and he turns it over, trying to find his teammate, Tolliver. 17 turnovers for the Comets. Here's Drew Joyce, dribbles baseline into some trouble. And the Fighting Irish give it right back. Ariza loses the handle.
James go!
Oh my goodness. His head was about a foot over the rim.
Here we go!
Look at the crowd! Did you see the entire building stand up at one time?
Give me a timeout! Give me a timeout!
Young guy's got some hops as he gets up. Back-to-back jams by LeBron James. And this place is speechless right now.
They got his mom. Back-to-back, here it is again. Look at how high he gets up. The floor. Flight 2-3.
37 for LeBron James.
Homeowners are as individual as the house.
Guys, we're going to just let the pictures do the talking here.
So now, is he in the NBA dunk contest tonight, right? Tonight's the NBA dunk contest? Well, this guy should be in it, because you know what? He'd be walking away with hardware.
Hey, Dick Vitale was right.
Oh, yeah.
By far. I mean, I'm sitting at the, I'm sitting court row.
Pick him apart.
By far, the best high school player with hype that I've seen, TV or in person.
Well, certainly the best performance you've ever seen by a guy like that. But still, if you talk to old-time guys who have seen a ton of high school basketball, like Tom Kinchowski and guys like that, Lou Alcindor is still the guy that they say was the most dominant high school player. You go back further, guys talk about Wilt Chamberlain at Overbrook High School, dominated the game beyond belief, but he is the most electrifying high school player. And certainly right now, tonight, you're seeing one of the greatest performances ever by a high school guy with this type of hype. Come on.
Three-point offering is short by Gerard Moret. Here's James going to the left hand. That's 39 points for LeBron. His career high is 50.
That's a la Kobe right there. That, remember, you see the highlights of Kobe with the extension of both hands.
He glides out in the open floor. He covers so much ground so effortlessly.
Comets desperate for some offense. The tip in by Scott Cutler.
Nice.
The no-look offering by LeBron James, and there you see the unselfishness.
And that's what he does best. He's got court vision. He's two passes ahead of everybody.
Here's Moret, baseline jumper, and he's able to rattle it home. A 21-point lead for the Fighting Irish.
If you're Westchester, how do you respond to this?
Well, right now, you're a deer in headlights. I mean, you can't believe what's going on.
Oh! And Corey Jones getting into it, the junior guard with the three-pointer.
And his teammates feed off him. All of a sudden, he gets on a run, and here come his teammates with him.
Syed Cotton getting a hand on it. And LeBron James comes up with the loose ball. Dangerous pass taken by the point guard, Drew Joyce. Right back to LeBron. Gets a screen from Cotton.
Great.
Five Jones wide open. Offensive rebound taken by Cotton. Now to Joyce. As it's stripped away, fight for it. And it's picked up by Cutley. Now to Moret. Up ahead for Brown with LeBron trailing it. And Bobby Brown kisses it off the window.
LeBron might need a blow.
A little tired right now. You're going to see him coming into your screen, slowly getting up the court.
Spent the last 10 minutes in the air.
LeBron falling
maybe
away.
He's not that tired. Oh, my.
Make it 42 points and counting.
He's turned the game into a sideshow. The game is no longer a story at all.
Welcome back, LeBron.
That's Jonathan Tolliver over the outstretched arms of James. Now Joyce weaving through traffic. LeBron wide open, and it rims out. One of his rare misses on the afternoon.
Oh, he's struggling a little bit, too, to get back defensively. That time off has really hurt him a little bit. I mean, hurt him turning 42 points, but...
Yeah, it really slowed his game down.
Here's Brown on a three-pointer short, and the rebound taken by Romeo Travis.
Coach Bruce may want to give him a quick blow.
LeBron James has scored 42 of his team's 57 points. He's 17 of 26 shooting.
And it seems more like 62. Because they're all highlight shots, whether it's a three-stepping back or dunking on guys. It seems like it's more than 42.
Teammates have had some open looks. Here's Cotton off the miss by Jones, and Cyan Cotton. It's a nice round of applause, working very hard. And Cyan Cotton, a guy who is signed with Ohio State to play football. Very talented all-around athlete. And we get a timeout. A tremendous display of high school basketball.
And the extension, the left hand. And then running the floor. How about the pass? The look away.
St. Vincent St. Mary with a 25-point lead. More from Trenton in a moment. The nation's top-ranked high school team, St. Vincent St. Mary, sprinted out to a 25-point lead, 59-34 against 7th-ranked Westchester High School out of Los Angeles, California. And they have ridden the shoulders of that young man, LeBron James, 42 points on 17 of 26 shooting. And James has done it in a wide array of ways tonight. And that is Scott Cutley off the timeout. Nice play diagram by Comets head coach Ed Azal.
And as you said, Tate, he was a little winded, so they get him a rest. And all of a sudden, everybody takes a big sigh, tries to catch their breath.
Gorgeous move up and under on the reverse finish by Marcus Johnson, a freshman guard. Here's a three-pointer, short, as Tolliver misfires. Here's Drew Joyce.
And I said during the break, it's just amazing how you have one great player like Michael Jordan leave, and then you have another one coming in. But look, Bob, as you said, give some homage to the guys who have come before. Here you see a nice move up and under by the freshman. But what I mean by that is, due to the media, these kids are able to follow and emulate the Michael Jordans or the Vince Carters or the Tracy McGrady's, and their game has elevated a lot quicker. Obviously, you cannot teach what LeBron James brings in athleticism, but his team is not doing bad at all. He's got fundamentally sound players as well. I think, really, you don't get a chance to appreciate the other guys because James creates such a hoopla when he has the ball.
No, they're a terrific team.
Here's James back into the game. Nearly lost it, stays with it. And he puts it down with the left hand, again showing the ability to go to that weak hand right in front of the basket.
Finishing around the rim with either hand, that just makes him that much more difficult to try to stop. You can't. He's unstoppable at the offensive end.
He's got one of those games that you just shake your head.
Oh, yeah.
James now with 44. He could build on that total. One-on-one. Jump stop.
Wow. Wow.
He's amazing himself.
Yeah. He's even got himself shaking his head and laughing, saying, oh my.
LeBron making it up as he goes here tonight. He has 46 points. There's a three-pointer, and it falls through. Bobby Brown thought he was fouled.
And so did the coaching staff. They were right on top of the officials on that one.
LeBron James with it in his hands, his team leading this game by 26 points.
So now he'll show you his handle as well.
He's isolated against Marcus Johnson. James up and under, absorbs the contact, and a blocking foul called.
You said it, making it up as he goes along. Watch the jump stop right here. He knows that the defender's going to try to run through him, so he switches the ball over into the right side and the finger roll. A la George Gervin, he's got a little bit of everybody's game going.
Well, the bounce, it's hard to emulate. You know, you can't just watch at home and see how he does it. It's even more impressive when you're watching here in person. He's got the soft feet, the soft hands, and he gathers himself, even though he's moving 1,000 miles a minute. And he makes it look just effortless as he goes to the basket.
And all this with all that pressure, all that notoriety, everybody looking at him, that is just simply amazing.
A national audience is witnessing a tremendous young talent develop. LeBron James, just 18 years of age, headed for stardom in the National Basketball Association as he plays out his high school career. Here's Corey Jones fighting hard for it on the floor. And a jump ball is called by the officials. The possession arrow favors the Fighting Irish.
And to think, a couple jerseys almost kept him off the floor tonight. You know what I mean? Put that in perspective. Yeah. You would have missed this.
Yeah. And I think he wanted to show everyone, too. A lot of people supporting him on it. You know,
there is James.
Yeah, if he had made that, I would have left the
building. You're going over the table, onto the floor to high-five him, huh?
Three quarters complete here in Trenton, New Jersey. LeBron James, 47 points. And we still have 8 minutes to play. St. Vincent St. Mary, big over Westchester.
Sunshine.
Spiro Dinas, Tate George, and Rob Kennedy on hand courtside. 25th annual primetime shootout here in Trenton, New Jersey. The nation's top-ranked team, St. Vincent St. Mary's out of Akron, Ohio. Sprinted its way to a big lead, 66-39 against 7th-ranked Westchester out of Los Angeles. Start of the fourth quarter, here's Ariza. He's been overshadowed tonight and then some by LeBron James as James forces Ariza to change his shot. And back come the Fighting Irish. James, a pull-up three-pointer. He's short with it, but he follows his own miss. Ariza trying to pick his pocket. And a reaching foul called against Westchester. LeBron James with a little smirk in the direction of Ariza.
What's interesting, too, is he looks right in your eyes. You know, he's still, and he's waiting for a guy to give him the eye contact to create the challenge. And a lot of the Westchester players are looking right past him. You know, you almost want to anticipate someone's going to step up.
He's got that killer instinct. You know, like you said, looking right in his eyes, saying, you know what, you can't handle me, and I'm going to let you know about it.
Right.
Here's James down low, lays it up and in very gently with both hands. 49 points for LeBron. Saw the shooting percentages, 53-47 favoring the Fighting Irish. Westchester, dangerous pass down low. Tolliver trying to find Cutley. He will retain possession, last touched by the Irish. Just under a minute gone by, final quarter. Tolliver off the mark on the inbounds play. And LeBron James saves it along the baseline. Now Weems.
They concede to him every time down the floor. They give him the ball, let him create.
James weaving his way through traffic, short with the left-handed finger roll. Here's Johnson in the open floor. Pulls up baseline, and he buries the short jumper. Marcus Johnson, a sophomore forward. One of the top sophomores on the West Coast. Here's Corey Jones, guarded by Brown. Around the horn to Romeo Travis, who's been very quiet tonight.
Well, it's hard to make much noise when James is going to throw up 49.
And he's touching the ball every time down.
James wants more, falling away along the baseline, is bumped and fouled in the act. And now LeBron James will make his way to the free throw line and a chance to tie and eventually break his career high of 50 points.
I tell you, his mom is just as entertaining to watch. When he makes the move,
oh, yeah,
when he gets the ball, she's making the moves with him.
There's Gloria up there, and why not?
LeBron off the mark on his free throw.
And he's looking at her. She's his biggest critic. I mean, he misses the free throw. She's clocking like, come on, make the free throw.
A lot of yellow and green colors in the stands as LeBron James is able to convert on one of two, and he's tied his career high of 50 points. Unbelievable performance tonight by the 18-year-old James.
He likes this building. Had 36 here last year against Oak Hill Academy.
He is mesmerized, better than 10,000 in this building. And plenty more watching at home. James has his jumper rimmed in and out. Now Johnson works along the wing. Westchester running out of clock. Here's a corner three-pointer by Tolliver, short, and the rebound taken by Weaves.
Numbers.
Here's Drew Joyce pushing into the corner.
You see Joyce, he knows what type of game he's got. They're in transition. He's not running to the basket. He's spotting up from three. Knocks down his number.
He is the Paxton.
Yeah, exactly, right? Spotting up, making a living off LeBron James.
Two-point field goal is off the mark by Ariza. Talking about Corey Jones, a junior guard, 6'1", known for his outside shooting. He has 9 points tonight. And he has been a beneficiary of playing alongside LeBron James. Giving him some wide open looks from the outside. And give him credit, he's knocked him down tonight. And we will get a timeout. 5 minutes, 15 seconds left to play. Fourth quarter in Trenton. St. Mary, 72-41.
Look at that.
It's a new Tacoma.
Four-door.
Shine.
LeBron James adding on to his high school highlight reel, and this just in the third quarter.
I mean, this is a season worth of highlights for some guys. For him, it's just 8 minutes of play.
Flight 23. Oh, here's the other one.
And these dunks came back to back in a span of just a few seconds.
Oh, my goodness. The extension with the left hand. And one.
Little contact just bumps off people. His vision, he sees the floor, knocking down threes. He has done everything that you could ask of a basketball player here this evening.
And you just said that was the third quarter.
Yep.
You showed that in the half.
8 minutes. And you got 19 points here in the second half he's got.
And you
got
to think, guys, the time away for LeBron, about a week or so away from his teammates, made him really regroup and appreciate the time he has with his high school teammates. Here's Trevor Ariza off the steal, right to the basket. And they say the foul came before the shot attempts. And it will be Westchester basketball. They'll inbound along the baseline. That's just the third team foul against the Fighting Irish.
Frustration on the Westchester bench. They just got tagged with a technical foul.
Foul was called on Drew Joyce, and then Ed Azam, the Westchester High School head coach, teed up by the far side official.
Well, the hardest part is the kids for Westchester. You can't prepare for this.
No.
You can't prepare for this.
Remember, this is a terrific high school basketball team, ranked 7th in the country coming in. It's a program with great tradition. Won the state championship last year with 5 Division I players. I mean, but you're right. You cannot prepare for what LeBron James has done.
Man, you've got to bring a high-level college kid to come in and practice with them just to simulate what it would be like for that type of intensity. Because I said when he first came out, he looked a little lackadaisical and then turned it on.
And I don't think there is a high-level college player that could do what he does.
Drew Joyce converts on 1 of 2 on the technical free throws. And he pushes to a 32-point Fighting Irish lead. Here's Joyce in the front court. Guarded closely by Bobby Brown. Into the corner. Weaves a three-pointer. And he rattles it home.
James with the open three-point look because LeBron James set the nice screen in their half-court offense.
Weaves, a junior guard, listed at 6'1". Here's Ariza. Guarded by LeBron James, top of the arc. Ball worked around to McClinton. Now back out for Ariza. He's isolated against James, into the corner. Brown looks for a teammate. We approach 4 minutes left to play in this fourth quarter. Ariza, James plays about 2 feet off of him. Ariza challenges James, misfires, follows his own miss, and he lays it up and in with the left hand.
He's playing above the rim. He's just been shut down. He hasn't had enough good looks. Just the 4 field goal attempts in the first half, they just haven't been able to go to him enough.
12 points tonight for Trevor Ariza.
Those are his first 2 points here of the second half.
Now look who they have guarding James now. They've gone small.
Try something, huh? He's got 50. Small, big, I don't think it matters.
James guarded by McClinton, falling away baseline, and why not? And he has now surpassed his career high, 52 points for LeBron James.
Small, big, one guy, two guys, it doesn't matter.
Brown trying to answer, misfires on the three-pointer. And Scott Cutley gets on the offensive boards. Here's Ariza.
So you have to make James guard. That's a bailout. And now all he does is rest on defense. And now you're going to see him put the show on.
James shuffles to his teammate Joyce, an air ball. As Joyce misfires from 19 feet, Cutley stays with it, lost the handle momentarily, and Cutley is able to lay it up and in with the right hand. Cutley again has committed to Kent State.
Now he's got another guy, they switched off.
Under 3 minutes to play in regulation. James wants more. He has 52 points. Turns and faces on Moret. James.
They all look like they're going in.
Tough pass for Bobby Brown to handle. Off his hands, out of bounds. As Westchester turns it over.
There is one that did go in. Gets him his career high. Now at 52. The fadeaway. And here he is coming out of the game, and listen to the crowd. They appreciate what he's done here this evening.
And he's got his arms up because more than anything, we talked about his youth, but he wants to play. You know, he's not concerned about the Hummer and the T-shirts, and here's his mom coming down. He'd probably give him a hug. They went through a lot this past week.
And his mother, Gloria, trying to make her way down to the bench to congratulate her son. Still 2 minutes and change left to play. He comes off the bench for the first time tonight. Outside jumper for Johnson is off the heel of the rim. And Danzy tracks it down. An offensive rebound.
I tell you, this school will never recover from this. They will need another miracle.
Final 2 minutes as Glasper lost the handle. And it's knocked out of bounds. And they say last touch by the Comets. It will be Fighting Irish basketball. But first, we'll get a timeout. The night has belonged to LeBron James and his St. Vincent St.Mary team. A huge lead over Westchester.
Versatile, most exhilarating watercraft.
Sports news. Weeknights at 10 on Sunshine.
Final minute 46 as the crowd slowly begins to trickle towards the exits. They certainly got their money's worth tonight. LeBron James outscoring the entire Westchester team 52-45.
You even got your money if you had to scalp one to get in here tonight.
And we are going to try to get LeBron to do a little post-game interview with us, but that's a challenge in and of itself. Got to go through the entourage, a lot of checks and balances to get to LeBron these days.
What I really enjoy, put his arms up, not to boast, but to say, you know what, I wanted to be here. He could have easily gone to Atlanta and said, I don't need this. You know what I mean? All I want to do is play basketball. And I made some mistakes, and yet I want a chance to play.
And you said it, Tate. He doesn't get enough credit for that. Right. I mean, the easy thing is to go sign a contract and put that money in the bank. Instead, he wants to win a state championship because, you know what? Even though he's totally special and different than everybody else, he still is a high school student. He's a good student in the classroom. He's a good guy off the floor, and he's just absolutely unbelievable on the floor.
Well, part of it, too, when you take a person's livelihood away and he wants to play, not that he's making money at the high school level, but he comes out and gets his career high to say thank you to the fans because they packed it in to see him play.
We approach 1 minute left to play. Danzy's offering partially blocked by Andre Dunn. Westchester trying to answer. Dunn misfires. Back out, it's taken by Joey Knox, who's checked in. Both teams emptying their benches. Final 50 seconds. That ball saved by Granville. Inside play is up and good by Joey Knox. Fighting Irish with the basketball leading 78-47. Turnaround jumper is off the mark by Danzy. Up ahead for Granville, freshman guard. Across the lane, jump stop. misfires. The rebound putback is up and good by Jarrell Lake. And whistle stops play. 22.6 seconds left. And assuming this will be our final stoppage, a 30-second timeout.
Again, the career high.
52 points tonight for LeBron James. The fifth time that he has eclipsed 40 points in his high school career. 21 of 35. And he was 4 or 6 of 10, rather, from three-point distance. A dazzling performance by the 18-year-old LeBron James.
And from start to finish, he got out defensively, a couple deflections, scored it in transition, and he never let up.
Here comes the mom.
Gloria James showing a lot of similarities to Iverson's mother.
Yep.
Similar relationship between James and his mother and Allen Iverson.
Think of all they've been through the last week to be able to step out and have this kind of performance. Boy, that says a ton.
Well, that shows you, too, the camaraderie in their family. Single mom raising her kid, much like Allen Iverson's mom. And again, when you grow up in that type of environment, You live for these moments. You don't run away from them. And your family has as much to do with it as much as you do, because they're your support system. And you have to love the type of love that comes from the mother to him in this situation.
Final second. And it falls through, but too little, too late. For the seventh-ranked team in the country, Westchester High School. Final score from Sovereign Bank Arena. St. Vincent St. Mary, 78. And Westchester, 52. A show-stopping performance by LeBron James. A career high for him tonight. 52 points. And he leads the Fighting Irish, the nation's top-ranked high school team, to a big victory here in the 25th annual primetime shootout. Tate, what'd you think?
I'm in shock. I didn't anticipate, you know, this much going on. And I said it earlier, you know, it's one thing to be hyped up and not live up to it. But, you know, when you live up to the hype, I think he's one of the best players that I've seen with the hype.
And LeBron James making his way over. 52 points tonight for him, a career high, as the Fighting Irish win in convincing fashion over seventh-ranked Westchester High School out of Los Angeles, California. Now standing by, LeBron James with our Rob Kennedy. Rob, take it away.
Thanks a lot, Spiro. And LeBron, with everything that's been going on over the last 2 weeks, how in the world did you stay focused and come out and put on this type of performance?
No, once again, I'm out here with my teammates. You know, anytime I'm with my teammates, I'm so focused. And this court, you know, the basketball court for me is like a house for me. You know, when you're in your house, you're comfortable. And that's how it was for me tonight.
And being away from your house for the last couple weeks, all of a sudden you seemed a little riled up tonight, trying to take things on offensively, and it looked like you had a little extra motivation, no question, huh?
Well, you know, I think missing the game last week gave me a little bit more motivation and ready to get back on the court with my teammates. And tonight we just wanted to come out and prove to the people in the USA Today that we should be the number one team in the country, as we are.
And that's the thing. Sometimes it's lost. Your team, the number one team in the country. You came out and whacked the number seven team in the country, so it's not just you. It is your teammates. Sometimes I think other people lose sight of that.
You know, every time we come out, we just try to play 110%. We got a great role cast, and, you know, you put me on the team, you know, it's great for our team. And, you know, being the number one team in the country, we got a bullseye on our back. We just try to play as hard as we can.
Talk about a bullseye. You've got a bullseye on your back as well, all the media attention, but again, that focus. Now for you, there's so much still ahead of you, but this season, obviously you want to get back to the state finals this time, once again, get over the hump. What's that like for you? How important is that?
Well, you know, the state finals are so far away. We're just trying to take every week and every day by day. You know, just trying to get better as a team every day, and hopefully we can get back to the state finals again.
All right, and again, we appreciate you. I tell you what, thanks, man. That was a heck of a performance. Spiro?
An unbelievable performance by LeBron James tonight. And our thanks to LeBron for checking in post-game and A dazzling performance by him, and more importantly, a win for his high school team, St. Vincent St. Mary, tonight over 7th-ranked Westchester High School out of Los Angeles, California. For those of you watching across the country on our network affiliates, we thank you for tuning in tonight, the 2003 Primetime Shootout. And for those of you watching on Yes, stay tuned, more to come. Stay with us.
Experience the legendary feel of a Fluger.
We welcome you back live to Sovereign Bank Arena in Trenton, New Jersey. The final score, St. Vincent St. Mary, big over Westchester High School tonight, 78-52. And we welcome you back, Spiro Dedis, alongside Tate George and Rob Kennedy. And guys, the final days for LeBron James as an amateur athlete on the high school level, reinstated by the Ohio Athletic Association a few days ago, and he comes up tonight a career-high 52 points, showing every facet of his game.
Amazing. I mean, just absolutely amazing. He was spectacular, but again, with everything surrounding this game, for him to step out and play like that, speechless.
Well, Rob, the interview is what I was impressed about. Coming off the stage, how about the crowd around him? And he's articulate. He took his time. He listened to every question. He talked about the team and the importance of the team. And again, you talk about him wanting to play the game, and it's hard to find guys that you want to make a hero, but I'm going to put him on my list because he did a great job under this pressure.
Yeah, special. The poise of this young man is absolutely amazing. Not just his poise on the basketball court, as you're saying, Tate, but his poise with the media and everybody else, just absolutely spectacular. That's why he's getting this type of attention. He clearly is the star of the future.
Definitely. And when you watch him, you talk about a guy, the athleticism, his ability to stand up and be accounted for. He apologized for taking the jerseys, and then he comes back and says, I gave him back. Let's play basketball. He's happy to be playing with his teammates. What more can you ask for?
Such a poised young man, just 18 years of age, and with all the attention, you're right. He comes back, fights through all the off-the-court problems, and he's trying to fight through all that right now, and he's really showing what he's made of.
The thing is, he's not just like Michael Jordan on the basketball court. He's Michael Jackson. I mean, look at the crowd that just walked with him over here to go take this interview. It's amazing, but he handles it all so professionally. It really is something special.
He'll get better, and as he gets better, the expectations are going to grow. But there are guys that are down in Atlanta that are expecting him to do this, and he outscored the other team tonight. And when you do that, it's going to reverberate all the way back down the East Coast, and they will hear about it.
And I guarantee you it will be the talk of the NBA All-Star game. Guys will be talking about the performance he laid here tonight, no question.
We were all blessed to be in, and I really feel that way. When you get a chance to see a kid this young do these great things and also able to transform the game, you have to be, happy that you're here to see it.
A career performance for LeBron James in the final few games of his high school career. He comes forth tonight with a career-high 52 points. But more importantly, he leads his team to a victory. St. Vincent St. Mary, a big win. And they ran through this Westchester team, a very talented high school team.
And again, they're the number one team in the country, not just because they have the number one player, but I think it has a little bit to do with it, huh?
Well, I like the players that he play with, too. Yep. You can they blend in. They don't seem to complain. They know he's going to get the ball a lot, but they make the shots when they have them, and they're going to, they're going to rebound. They won't have a LeBron James next year, but the coach, they will make that adjustment, and he's got some other players that's going to D1. You talked about it, Rob.
And everybody accepts their role, and they know that the first thing you got to do is ride your superstar, and boy, when he puts them on his back, he takes them wherever he wants to.
So better than 10,000 crammed into this building, and they walk out with plenty to talk about. Final score, St. Vincent St. Mary over Westchester, 78-52. A pleasure working tonight with former UConn star Tate George and our high school hoops aficionado Rob Kennedy. Special thanks to producer Steve Danz, director Norm Savitt, and executive producer John Filippelli. Again, the final score tonight, St. Vincent St. Mary 78, Westchester 52. And thank you for watching the Primetime Shootout. Up next, Lanier and St. Raymond. Stay with us.
Coming up on the FHSAA Sports Report presented by Dodge, host Bernie Gunther is in Gainesville to find out what a day